until now. The piece achieved performing some simple purpose adequately, in full view of the public, but with her dignity and mystery intact. Operating the blistering, groaning espresso machine, pumping out plugs of steam-soaked coffee and tamping fresh grind in its place, venting the pressured steam through the valves in controlled bursts, flash toweling grit from the joints and threads before burning your fingers, was like playing bass, an anonymous service full of secret satisfaction and precision, clarity, tempo. And it brought her a version of fame. She watched the cafe's customers recognize her everywhere she went, but declined their glances. Falmouth's callers, by comparison, tugged at her private self, blotted at her with their egos. Falmouth would be lucky if some museum purchased his lunatic archive of woe and stored it in its basement, there to rot. Complaint was a tide, a drab surf rinsing up everywhere, and by declaring his project, Falmouth had drawn the tide to his door. But the complaints existed before Falmouth, and they'd go on after. No one should be forced to listen to it. She couldn't be paid enough. Let Falmouth take the calls himself. That's what the student would have liked to tell the reporter for the annoyance. That was her complaint. Why hadn't